What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Kayla. If you didn't know, now you know. And today is just going to be a makeup tutorial for beginners. Basically, it's going to be a tutorial for what I know or what I do. So if you want to do it as well, feel free and comment down below if you learned anything new in this video. So basically, I did a poll on Instagram. I created two different looks. I created a pink one, and then I created like a brownish look. I did a poll to see which look you guys would want to see on my channel, and you guys completely blew that brown look out of the door. I was like, dang, like, what the brown one do to y'all? But this video is long overdue. I was planning on recording this video for maybe like the past 2 weeks. And now school started, so it's definitely like, ooh. But you can still expect new videos every Thursday, 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. With that being said, before we get into this video, actually, make sure you click the subscribe button down below so you can become part of the original fam. Also, turn that post notification bell so every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, you can be notified when that video comes out, because you wouldn't want to miss it. You wouldn't want to miss it. And I think that's all I really have to say. Oh, make sure you follow my social medias. It's going to be there. So let's get into this video. Yeah. All right, you guys. So I'm going to start off with my eyes first. Don't mind my hair. We're going to do that later. Fix it up and do a little cute little hairstyle or whatever the case may be was. So you already know. Oh, that's where that's coming. Yeah, that's actually kind of disgusting. I think that's might be lip gloss on the, I'm disturbed. I'm going to start off with the eyes first. Like, if you haven't seen my eyebrow tutorial, I suggest you click right there. It'll be up there. If you haven't seen it, go see it, go believe it, go dream it. We're just gonna start off with the eyebrows as soon as I get my life together and find the brush that I need. I'm doing my eyebrows. I'm going to speed this part up. You guys have a tutorial up already.
Oh my god, it's DJ Small.
Going to be going in with the shade Light Ivory from LA Girl Pro. Just going to prime my lids with this. Ooh. I'm gonna take my beauty blender and blend that out. Alright, so I look ridiculous. No. I can't be out here exposing myself on YouTube like that. I look crazy. Something I do to keep my looks clean and precise is I put tape on the like corners of my eyes. But before I do that, I'm actually going to set my eyes with some setting powder, because it was a trick I found, so yeah, I'm gonna just do that. I'm going to take this I'm going to take this small fluffy brush right here and my BH Ultimate Matte Palette, and we are going to go in with our first shade, which is this pink right here. I'm going to pat it in right there in the corner and bring it up. So you see how, because I use that lighter concealer, it's really starting to pop off the bat. We're patting, we're not blending anything out, we're just getting that color payoff, as the other YouTubers that I've watched like to say. And I'm literally just gonna pat that in and follow the my natural crease. I'm also going to bring it up a little bit because my eyelids are hooded, and when I cut the crease, I want it to be seen, but I don't want to lose this color because this is the main color. So literally going to just pat that in. Okay, now that that's pat in, I don't really care for this to not be as pigmented, but I really want that to be pigmented. So now that that's colored, patted in, we're gonna blend upwards towards the brow bone very lightly. And that's why I'm holding the brush over here instead of right here. I don't want to blend it out all the way. Just wanna bring it up a little bit. You can always go back into that first shade you want, pat it in there, and make it as precise as you would like it to be. This shade right here, I lost the plastic, or I threw it away, so I don't know what it's called, but we're gonna go in with that shade right there. And we're just gonna pat above. We're not blending anything. We're literally just patting it above and following that same shape. And you probably cannot see it, so let me just move it a little bit closer. Focus, please. I'll wait. Okay. So you probably cannot see it, but it is a very light shade right there, outlining that pink. I'm gonna blend them together and get rid of that harsh line. Once again, holding the brush far away so you're not blending out too harshly. If you feel like you're losing that first dark shade of pink, you can always go back in and touch it up. Keep blending if you want to. For me, I feel like this little gradient effect that I have going on is good. It's not too much, not too little. So now I'm gonna move on to, I'm gonna do the other eye and then come back and do the cut crease. So I'm gonna speed this part up.
Oh my god, it's DJ Small.
Okay, so now that that is blended out, you're no longer going to use this palette. I actually forgot to go get the one that I did use, so I'll be right back. BH palette, if you couldn't tell, I'm probably obsessed with BH. This is the Fairy Lights palette. You guys have seen it before, so yeah. So now we're going to cut the crease, and when I cut my crease, I use this flat, rounded brush. So I'm going to take that same light concealer, just gonna get it on there, and we are going to outline, we're going to follow the outline of our natural eye. And just bring it. I personally don't do this or put my eyes down because my eyes are hooded. So I keep them straight so I know where my hood is and where I can stop my crease. It's not a full cut crease, so you're going to just stop it halfway. And then clean up the line. And it's okay if you don't get it right the first time. I still don't get it right the first time. I watch a lot of the YouTubers that I've been learning from. They cut creases be crisp, sharp, and I'd be there like, wow. So after that, I'm just going to continue to clean up that line, make it as rounded as possible, and just take my time. So now that that's done, I'm gonna clean this brush off, and I'm just gonna blend it down. Now I'm gonna take some more concealer. I'm just going to fill in that space. And I'm really stopping it right here. Not really half my lid, but a little bit. Like maybe like 3/4 of my lid. This is how first cut crease is looking. See how when I look forward, you can still see where I cut that crease. So now what I'm going to do is, I lied about not using this palette again. I'm actually going to go back in, and with that first shade that we use, I'm going to take that shade and basically blend that into the edge of the cut crease. So I'm going to pat it on first, and then we're going to blend and just blend inwards. So I'm going to go in with, I'm not going to go in with anything. I'm going to do the next side now. And come back. I would recommend starting off low, looking, going back in, and then bringing it higher if you need to. So as you can see, mine, that space that's right there, it does not exist here. So, just gonna go in. Get rid of that space. Explore, baby. Okay. That's done. We're gonna go back in with that powder and gently set an eyelid. Then, just like the other eye, we're going to go back into that BH Cosmetics matte palette and blur out the edges of that cut crease. Now, I've seen some people, depending on the look, they would go in with like a black or a darker shade and outline the cut crease to give it depth. I would love to do that, but I'm not going to. See, the thing is, before I even attempt to put these makeup looks on here, I always practice some once or twice before I even decide to record them, which is why I'm recording this one now. So I know what I'm doing, I know the order of how I did it, and I know how I'm gonna do it now. So that's basically what you're getting now. I did this look maybe about 3 times before I decided to do that. So the next step is we're going to go into our BH Cosmetics palette, the Fairy Lights one. This is also, oh, it's not matte or anything, it's just shadow, I think. Yeah, it's not matte. So we're gonna go into this palette, and I'm going to get a dense packer brush that I used. We're going to go into this palette, and we're going to take this light pink shade, Radiant. And I'm going to use this dense little small packer brush, and we are literally going to, from the corner, and we're just going to pack that on. That same brush that we used for the first and second shade, and we're just going to blur that harsh line between the two. Okay, so here's what the eyes looking like. We have dark on the inside, light on the outside. What? Dark on the outside, light on the inside. Nice simple cut crease look. Something simple, something easy, very beginner friendly. So now that that's done, we're basically going to just move in and finish the rest of the face. Now we're just going to move into the Fenty. I heard you're supposed to shake it. I don't want too much on me because if I'm not going out and like I'm just doing something like this, like a tutorial, I tend to not put a lot of makeup on me, but I put enough. So, whoa. Again. I tend to not put a lot of makeup on my face because it just makes the takeoff, like the removal process, so much easier.
Oh my god, it's DJ Small. I'm gonna close.
product. Please do not mind my hair. She's 3 weeks old, 2 weeks old, three weeks. She's getting crusty. She's getting dusty. She needs to be washed and she needs to be styled. I'm thinking about doing Marley twist, like some long, medium type length. I really want to try that hairstyle out. So comment down below if you want to see a tutorial on that. I'm also going to do a Instagram poll, so make sure you follow my social media so you can participate in that and find out whether or not I'll be doing that video next. To end this video and you like this makeup look, comment down a pink heart with the sparkles, or comment down any pink heart. Matter of fact, comment down any pink heart. I don't really care which one it is. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Make sure you click the subscribe button down below so you can become part of the original fam. Also, so you can be notified whenever I post a new video. Every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Follow my social media so you can be caught up with me in my daily life, even though I don't really have one because of Corona. And I am I'm a college student, so there's that. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching this video. And I will see you in the next one. Bye!